Hey, my name's Sean Mysel. I'm a paid media buyer that's sold over $325 million on cold traffic. And I'm really excited to share with you a technique I've been using on YouTube ads to scale. And I'm talking about scaling everything from like these types of products to services to high ticket, low ticket, it doesn't matter. And what I've done is I prepared a video where you can see exactly the steps you need to take to make it work. But first, before you do that, just like this video, subscribe to our channel, and I'm going to show you exactly how it's done. All right, so let's take a look at this YouTube one-two punch strategy. And what I want to show you is I'm going to back out and show you how to make this work to an extent that you can confidently make some serious money. So what I'm showing you right here is this is an ad campaign for a higher ticket product that we sell in cold traffic. You can see that the return on ad spend is 6.19. Not terrible, right? So here's what we're going to go do. The first step to doing this is to come here. And what we're doing is we're targeting people in a couple ways. We're targeting people who have gone on the page as a retargeting audience. Or if you prefer, if it's Google, it's remarketing, right? And we're also retargeting people who've watched videos where we've demonstrated the product and subscribers, okay? And people watch the ad video. Now, what this does is the content is going to give you an unlimited supply of warm traffic. So if you're selling a higher ticket product on cold traffic, you're going to need a few touch points. It's going to be rare that someone just comes right off the street, checks your ad out, reads your copy, and just says, all right, let's do it. You know, it's going to take a couple touch points. But I think you're going to be really pleasantly surprised if you've ever run retargeting traffic before. You know how expensive it can be. Wait till you see what I got for you. So first thing you do is you want to make videos. Ideally, if you have, whether you have a service or you're consulting or whatever, I'll give you a couple different scenarios for making the content. In this scenario, what we're doing is we're doing live demonstrations and shorts of what we call our power console. It's an arcade gaming console. All right. So this will be, you know, we'll classify this obviously as an e-com product. So what you'll see is we do a bunch of live streams, and it gets, you know, varying different. Some take off, some don't, and that's okay. We're still kind of learning the content game. But you can see all these videos. All these people are getting pixeled up to get retargeted by our ads. Okay. They have, and a lot of these people are subscribers. They have almost 4,000 subscribers. So they're watching these videos repeatedly. So they get to know us. All right. And then, of course, if we scroll down here, and I will show you because we have so many videos here. This is the main ad video. And you can see it has 22,777 views and so on. Okay. What we're doing is all of these are plus the page visits are combining to make a giant retargeting audience. And let me show you how you do that. So what you do is you come here. This is Google Ads. You're going to come up to Tools and Settings, and you're going to click Audience Manager. Click Audience Manager, okay? And what we want to do is it'll give you a bunch of different options, but I'm going to just pretend. Let's pretend that this audience doesn't exist. We're going to click the plus sign. And you go here and you see YouTube users. Boom. Click that. You just name it. We'll just put test YouTube video viewers. It'll ask you to pick your channel. Of course, mine comes up right there. And then you have some options. View any video. I would strongly suggest you do not do this unless all the videos are related to what you're selling. Because like I got one account that I manage where the guy has he does tax videos, and but he's trying to sell tax resolution services. So we're not picking anything about like 401ks or corporate taxes and stuff like that. We're not worrying about any of that. It's only stuff related to what he's selling. Now to do that, all you do is you pick view certain videos. And then you could just click this. I would not pay, unless you only have one video, I would just use the scroll down option, and you could see the boxes. You could just pick these, okay? And it'll just kind of, you know, it'll basically like, see, I'll pick this one, I'll pick that one, and so on. what you want to generally do is I like to keep my audiences kind of hot. So I do 30 days. Okay. You can go bigger than that. I think you can go up at least to 90 days. That's up to you. But if you do content on a regular basis, you are not going to need to do that. You can keep a very warm audience circulating in there. This stuff here, you don't really need to worry about. You could pre-fill. You could start with an empty segment. It's up to you. I don't think it's that important to worry about that. But let me show you this, man. This is. I think what you're going to really be impressed by is the cost per click. So, if we go to, if we go into the campaigns, and I'll go into the ad and assets, and I'm just going to show you over this month. All right. And you can see some of these, like cost per conversion is $32. Overall, it's about $91 for us. That's really, really good because we're selling something that's, you know, $1,250, or, you know, it ranges to $1,000 to $1,250. But look at the click-through rates. This is what I want to show you here is the click-through rates are over 2% and some of them are over 3%. So when you start doing that, what happens is your cost per click is going to be very, very low. All right. I mean, you look like 102 clicks on $32. You're paying 32 cents a click for retargeting traffic. You know, you're paying like you've spent $13 on 38 clicks. What that means is you're going to get a pretty much near endless circulation of warm traffic, like I mentioned earlier. So go do this. Make some content, and I the way I would suggest doing this. Make some shorts first, so 60 seconds or less. Ideally, what you would do is make them like 31 seconds to 59 seconds, because if it's over 30 seconds, you can link those videos to the longer videos that you're going to do. So what I would do is I would do a short video, then make a longer version of it, and you can usually just do this in one filming, so you don't have to duplicate. You can just cut out the 60 seconds that you need. Link them. A couple things happen. YouTube's really promoting short videos, so you should get a lot of views on those, or more than normal. And then if they like the short video, the viewer, and they click the end screen on your short video, then Google will promote the longer one too. You'll get more watch time. All kinds of good things happen. But the bigger thing is you're getting all these data points of people you can target to just kill it and get really inexpensive quality traffic. All right. So leave a comment below, let me know what you think, and I will see you in the next video. Now, if you follow those exact steps and you love making content, I guarantee you that this will work for you. It's working for a guy I know that's doing tax services. It's working for our own e-com store and a friend who's doing book sales. Just follow the exact steps. Just to recap, make content on YouTube exactly for the thing you're trying to sell. When you go in to run your ads, just target those videos only. Now, if you have other videos on your channel that are related to that, that's totally fine. But you're going to target those people, target the people that hit your landing page, and will get an endless supply of warm traffic where the cost per click will be very inexpensive, but it's qualified traffic that converts. And I'll see you in the next video.